Today we're having a look at the fill mode in Stitchmastery. If I activate the fill mode, you'll be able to see the icon a little bit more clearly. So it is a paint tin tipping over and the icon appears next to the edit font icon, so the capital T and small t, or next to the arrow select tool. And with fill mode, you activate it and then you select some stitches. So for instance, I could select this row or a number of rows if I hold down my shift button. And then you can click on a stitch or a colour and it will automatically fill all of those stitches. We can use the Marquee select tool to select some columns and pop in some purl stitches. I can select an irregular shaped area by first of all choosing one cell, or if you want to start with a rectangular area or a square, you can hold down the shift button and click somewhere else and Stitchmastery will create a rectangle or square. And then if I release the shift button and hold down my control button, or you could do command if you're on a Mac, you can then click to add other stitches to your selection. So I have now got this sort of kite diamond shape selected, and any stitch that will fit can be placed in. So for instance, we could pop in these, make one purl wise. Now of course my outline has given me lots of errors because I've added a load of increases, but I've not actually added any extra stitches to my rounds to make them long enough to incorporate these. But this is just for the demonstration, so we'll not worry too much about that. You can also select the whole of the chart, and let's recolor that. And you can use stitches and colors that are in your key as well, so you don't always have to go and find them in the palette. Just a quick reminder to remember to switch off the fill mode by clicking again to deactivate it, and you'll know that it's deactivated with the red cross over it. That's just because if you go on to try and add a single stitch or do something else in your chart, you might get some strange results. But of course, there's always the undo button or control and Z.